There's a couple things I see. This is all off Virginia, by the way. It's the vacapes. So there's whiskey areas out there too. That's where NAS Oceana goes out and trains. They've tracked them at just sitting there. They've tracked them at high rates of speed. They've been tracked lots. The radars they're using now are even better than the ones that I had in the Super Hornet. It's pretty amazing. More advanced technology, you know, cooler stuff, more capable. They're seeing it. At first they thought they were, when they first saw it, they thought, oh, these are just ghost hits. And I'm like, no, that radar really doesn't provide ghost hits, which are false targets. It's pretty good. And then someone actually threw their targeting pod out there and there was something there, because you can't hide from the targeting pod if you've got any type of heat signature. And that's what really started this. But they've been seen by many people as far as on the radar. And there's been a couple that have seen visual because one guy almost hit one. It was just sitting there.
This is recent. This is real recent.
This is within the last 5 years.
Did they describe these things as conventional aircraft? How did they describe these things they almost hit, Dave?
They describe it as, well, the one that almost got hit was like a clear beach ball sphere with a cube inside, so the little apexes of each corner hit the cube. So I don't know if it's like a, you know, is it a beach ball or is it like a force field? I don't know. There's something around it. This is kind of what's prompting, I think they're getting heat from other avenues of the government because of what happened with our incident that, you know, hindsight being 2020, which is how I live my life. Probably should have done something about it. Maybe put a little effort into this. If not to go figure out what can come in and penetrate a battle group like that, but God, just what if we can harness that technology?